monitoring will come to your digital electronics and microprocessor be done with the class. So, if you get that, we have already discussed about the pin diagram of 8085 microprocessor. Today we'll discuss about stack, stack pointer, and stack pointer. So, what is stack? The stack is a repo that is wrapped in hardtop data structure implemented in the RAM area and is used to store addresses and data when the microprocessor branches place of the day. That is, the data which is inserted in RAM that must be deleted in hard. That is the taking of the stack. Then, stack pointer is the 16-bit SPRS register used to store the address of the data which is recently entered into the stack. That means the data which is recently inserted into the stack. That address or data address is indicated or pointed by the SPRS register. Then, what is stack top? The last memory location occupied by data in the stack is known as stack top. Data which is occupied in last memory location, that is known as the stack top. Then let's come to interrupt in 8085 microprocessor. So first, what is interrupt? Interrupts are the signals generated by the external devices to disturb the microprocessor to perform a task. To perform a task, the interrupt sends some request signal to the microprocessor. That request signal are known as interrupts. Then there are five interrupt signals, that is RAP, RST 7.5, RST 6.5, RST 5.5, and ISTR. Interrupts are classified into following groups based on their parameters. So first one is vector interrupt. In this type of interrupt, the interrupt address is known to the processor. For example, RST 7.5, RST 6.5, RST 5.5, and flag. These are all the vector interrupts. The next is non-vector interrupt. In this type of interrupt, the interrupt copy a register of data and address on which the opcode was. Next is differentiate between 1 byte, 2 byte, and 3 byte instruction is example. So first is 1 byte instruction. In 1 byte instruction, the opcode and the operand of an instruction are represented in 1 byte. So for example, move A comma B, add C, increment B, all are the example of 1 byte instruction. Here the instructions are of 1 byte. Then next is 2 byte instruction. 2 byte instruction is the type of instruction in which the first 8 bits indicate the opcode and the rest 8 bits indicate the operand. The 2 byte instruction will mean here 16 bits that memory address is required. So first 8 bits indicate the opcode and the rest 8 bits indicate the operand. For example, move MDI A, 58H. So here 58 indicates the opcode, then ADI 25H. 25 indicates the operand. So this is 2 byte instruction. Then let's come to 3 byte instruction. 3 byte instruction is the type of instruction in which the first 8 bits indicate the opcode and the next 2 bytes specify the 16 bit address. The low order address is represented in second byte and the high order address is represented in the third byte. For example, LDA 4000H, STM 2100H, all are the example of 3 byte instruction. So here, first LDA and STA. This 8 bit indicates the opcode and next 4000 and 2100 represent the 16 bit address. Next is addressing mode. So, different types of addressing modes are there. The first is direct addressing mode. In this addressing mode, the address of the operand of data is detailed in the instruction itself. For example, STA 2400H, it stores the content of the accumulator in the memory location 2400H. 32,00,24. The above instruction is the code. In this instruction, 2400H is the memory address where data is to be stored. It is given in the instruction itself. The second and third byte of the instruction specify the address of the memory location. Thus, it is understood that the source of the data is accumulator. Because the data is come from the accumulator. The source is the accumulator. Next is register addressing mode. In register addressing mode, the operand is in one of the general purpose registers. The code specifies the address of the register in addition to the operation to be performed. For example, move A comma B. So move the content of B register to register A. So 78. The instruction is the code form. In the above example, move A comma B is 78H. Besides, the operation to be performed, the code also specifies source and destination register. The code 78H can be written in binary form as 0111100. The first 2 bits that is 01 are for move operation. The next 3 bits 111 are the binary code for register A, and the last 3 bits 0000 and the binary code for register B. Then next is register indirect addressing mode. In register indirect mode of addressing, the address of the operand is specified by a register pair. For example, LXI H,2500H. It means load HL pair with 2500H. Then move A,N. Move the content of the memory location whose address is in HL pair, that is 2500H memory location, to the accumulator. So LXI H,2500 means load the HL pair to the 2500 memory location, and move A,L means move the content of memory location 2500H to the accumulator. Then HLC means halt, that means to stop the program. In the above program, the instruction move A,L is an example of the register indirect addressing. For this instruction, the operand is in the memory. The address of the memory is not directly there in the instruction. The address of the memory resides in HL pair, and this has already been specified by an earlier instruction in the program, that is LXI H,2500H. Then immediate addressing mode. In this addressing mode, the operand is specified within the instruction itself. For example, LXI H,2500 is an example of immediate addressing. 2500 is 16-bit data, which is then in the instruction itself. It is to be loaded into HL pair. Next is implicit addressing mode. There are certain instructions which operate on the content of the accumulator. Such instructions do not require the address of the operand. For example, CAA means complement the content of accumulator, RAL rotate the accumulator left, RAR rotate the accumulator right, etc. So this is all about